Hey everyone, welcome to round one. We have unfortunately lost the roll and we're looking at a fairly slow hand, one that I feel like I should mulligan. The main reason is we do have a divine verdict, but I would prefer to use that later on in the game where it's going to be more useful in the sense that I don't want to have to play divine verdict on turn four simply because I'm unable to play a creature and I'm just getting beaten down. I would prefer to save it for a point in the game where our opponent has decided to make a large creature or an attack in which case the divine verdict ends up being very crucial during that combat phase. So I'm going to ship this one. So we're going to mulligan, and this one is unfortunately not nearly as good. We only have one land, so we'll go ahead and mulligan to five. And this hand is pretty reasonable. We've got a Wingsteed Rider, and if we can draw two more lands, we should be able to make a Baneslayer Angel and then follow it up with the Silent Artisan. So we'll keep this hand and be off to the races, so to speak. This is our horse. Hopefully, if we bet correctly, we can win it with it. And we're playing against blue, it seems like. So, ooh, look, a Hoplite. Go ahead and play that. And now we'll... unfortunately, we're a bit low on cards. We don't have an island, so if we draw Ordeal of Thassa, it's not going to be that great to unmulligan. But for now, we're going to go ahead and attack for one and sort of put this guy on the back burner. We have a Wingsteed Rider to make it better, as a better bestow target, so we'll go ahead and just be attacking for one with the Hoplite for a while. And it looks like our opponent has nothing on turn three, so... the only question is whether or not we want to play around Stymied, the four spike scry one. But I would prefer not to, because I have the feeling that our opponent doesn't have it. But he does have a mountain, which means he'll probably be tapping up for some play, and we're going to bestow Hopeful Eidolon and hope that we're not. I guess we'll just bestow Hopeful Eidolon on our favorite Hoplite. Our favorite Hoplite. Build a Baneslayer. I'm not really sure why he did that on his turn. I guess he was playing around God's Wheeling, but since he hasn't seen that, it seems like it's not nearly as good. So we're going to go ahead and bash with this guy, and we can go ahead and F6, gain a bunch of life, and hopefully this will be good enough to win. I want to draw a land next turn so I could play this Artisan and then bestow Hopeful Eidolon on that. I would prefer... ugh. Okay, so here's an interesting little option. If we play the Eidolon on our Hoplite, that makes a three-turn clock. Makes Voyage's End pretty good, but I have the feeling that if he had Voyage's End in his hand, he would have cast it on his upkeep, so you could scry and potentially draw another land. So I'm going to go ahead and play this, and hopefully this will be good enough to win the game. Oh no, what is this? Is this a dissolve? It looks like a dissolve. That was unfortunate. Put it on the bottom also. Ugh. Well, we're going to go ahead and attack and punish him for him wanting to win the game, playing cards that are preventing us from doing so. So hopefully we can close this one out, but drawing an island would be pretty good. It'll unlock our hand, basically. Bronze Sable, you say? Well, there's no smite, so I'm just going to go ahead and run this guy into the red zone. Bam! And we haven't drawn an island yet, so we're just going to go ahead and lay out this Silent Artisan. Hopefully it gets there. Bronze Sable isn't the best card. I'll say that. We are presenting lethal damage now, and we have quite a few large toughness creatures. So it's going to be difficult to lose from this point, I think. And he's got 4 power, which isn't enough to kill any of our creatures. And so we're just going to bash with both. And this guy isn't going to be doing anything just because he has no mana. So we're going to hope that we get there. We're going to cool 35 life. And unfortunately, we don't have lethal with both of our creatures, so we're just going to have to run our dudes into the red zone. And what I imagine happening is, assuming he doesn't have Griptide in this particular scenario, is if he goes a double block, we'll use Divine Verdict, and then he'll concede the game. Because Divine Verdict sometimes does that when you're double blocking a large creature. So we'll go ahead and see what he's going to do. And we've got action. What is it? It could be anything. Bum ba dum. If he has Griptide, then I'm not going to bother using the Divine Verdict, because I would... Ooh. All right. So this is what's going to happen. He's probably going to double block. Favorite Hoplite. We are going to Divine Verdict Thassa's Emissary. He's going to concede. Whoa, Nelly. And there it is. We're going to go ahead and assign... Yeah, sure, it doesn't really matter. Let's go ahead and Divine Verdict this puppy right here. He's going to go to 1, assuming combat damage resolves. Here it is in 1. Oh, there we go. Mold of 5. Look at that. We were on the draw, but you know. All right, so what are we dealing with? We are dealing with blue-red. What did we see? What blue-red did we see during the draft? We saw various 4/4 6 mana sphinxes. Let's see. As far as in auras go, there is the emissary of Thassa, Thassa's emissary, so to speak. So Null gets a little bit better in that regard, but we already have a Ray. There's Last Breath, but we didn't really see too much that we actually want to kill. There is the Charlatan, but it's not really that big of a deal. And so since we're playing against blue also, that means that it is more likely that our opponent has ways to block our flyers by virtue of having flyers of himself. So we could board in Prowler's Helm. And looking at our deck, the weakest card is probably going to be something that it makes Lightning Strike good, which would be the Ordeal of Thassa, or basically just that. So I can see boarding out the Ordeal for Prowler's Helm. They both do sort of the same thing. Alternatively, we can board out a Battle Priest. This pick is kind of close, I think. Her decision's kind of close. So I think what we'll do is board out the Battle Priest, since it didn't appear that our opponent has very many early drop creatures other than the 2/1 and that sort of thing. So we'll board in the Prowler's Helm.